And so Mahinda, you're here in IBC to celebrate 100 years of Indian cinema. How has that, how's the technology changed in those years?
Well, we are, both the film and TV sectors are realizing the importance of having technology changes and world-class advancements to facilitate better revenues. So in context of that, I have taken an initiative of building up India's largest studio and bring in the latest technology in terms of having Hollywood benchmark sound stages for film and TV shoots, and also having content management and playout facilities for broadcasters, which is digitization of their content and then broadcasting that content worldwide. So this, ours will be the most modern content management facility and the first playout facility of India. And the sound stages will be the first of its kind in India. So that's in context to film and TV shoots, digitization, which is a big wave in India right now and all over the world. So that's a shift that we are seeing in the industry, and you know, Mumbai Media City is taking some of the first initiatives.
So you say you're building studios and also playouts. Has that not happened before in Bollywood?
Studios are dime a dozen, but there are no world-class sound stages in India, except a couple of small facilities which are mostly for internal use or not up to the mark. And so ours will be the first world-class facility for the industry to use, both TV and film. And as far as playout is concerned, there's no playout facility in India. There's a couple of small players, but again, they are not up to the mark to actually cater to the market in a big way. So we'll fill that gap. We have an international joint venture partner in place from Europe, and as we speak, our contracts are being finalized. So we'll bring the best technology to India in terms of playout and also content management, because even in content management, there's no world-class player in India, and we'll fill that gap. So both in content management, playout, and also in sound stages, you know, we'll be the best in India and the first proper player.
So does that mean that the what you're doing is part of a shift of technology from quite sort of old-fashioned film?
Exactly. Yes.
So how, say that, what's going on in the technology then?
In terms of technology, these technology options were not considered by the industry, and even if they consider, there was no initiative taken by any of the industry people to bring such kind of technology in India. So in terms of technology, as we spoke in the session earlier today, we'll have the Sholay movie in Dolby Atmos, which is a 128-track soundtrack technology, and that'll be the first movie in India to use that technology. And we've come a long way from the days when we had no Dolby in India, and then we had Dolby 5.1, 7.1, and now Atmos. And so there's, for example, in visual effects, in animation, Indian movies earlier used to be post-produced abroad, because there was no special effects or visual effects facilities in India. But now we have the best of the facilities in India, and the same, and we'll have the best, the best of the best in Mumbai Media City, VFX and animation both. And India is increasingly becoming an animation hub, working with the major Hollywood studios, not only just as a back-end outsource service provider, but also moving up the value chain and, creating stories and developing the entire story in India rather than just doing the technology piece of animation. So, and we will have, again, a European joint venture partner even for the animation piece. So there are technology shifts happening all over the industry, in television, movies, post-production, gaming, and Mumbai Media City will have all that and the best, and some of its initiatives are the first of its kind. Yeah, and overall, it's the first of its kind facility because it's world-class benchmarked, and it's right in the city, in the heart of the city. And there's no such facility with easy access, competitively priced, right, with the best technology in India.
Fantastic. Yeah.